And so we can open that up and have a look at the CPU part. Maybe we can open that up.
Push it.
Ah, back, that's right. I was trying to slide forward, sorry. Take two. So I'm Matt Gitzendanner, and I'm the training team lead here at Research Computing. So I manage the training program where we train students and faculty throughout the university, as well as other universities that use Hypergator. So this is the CPU tray of the DGX node. This box is kind of like what your main computer would have if at home. Your computer would probably only have one CPU that may have 8 cores these days is fairly standard for a desktop. So these CPUs have 64 cores, and we have 2 of them, and 2 terabytes of memory. You know, your computer may have 16, 32 gigabytes of memory. These have 2 terabytes of memory. So this is the GPU tray out of the DGX server. And so when we open that up, now we have those 8 A100 GPUs. So each of these is an A100 GPU, which is, again, very similar to the GPU you would have in your high-end gaming system, but much more powerful. So those high-end gaming system GPUs probably have 12 to maybe 20 gigabytes of memory per GPU. The A100s have 80 gigabytes of memory. There are 140 of these servers in the room, each with the 8 GPUs. So a total of 1,120 A100 GPUs in Hypergator AI. If we think about some of these large language models that are coming out from Facebook and Google, they are really the only companies that can afford the hardware to train those types of models. But with Hypergator AI, we have that power here as well. So if we have researchers that have huge models that need that many GPUs, we actually have the resources that can be used to train those types of models. All right, I think we're good. That one's all fixed, ready to go back in production.